I'm Kamaljeet. By qualification, I'm a fellow chartered accountant. I'm a certified fraud examiner, that is a US-based certification in corporate fraud investigation. Now, if I would like to talk about myself, so my journey has been very exciting, very full of ups and downs. I've served corporates for almost a decade, which includes the banks, multinational companies. And then in 2011, I took a conscious decision to leave the corporates because I was kind of done with the corporate hierarchies. Then I started my own venture called Cap Edge Solutions, that is majorly into fraud consulting and training. I started my journey in corporates back in 2003 after finishing my CM first attempt. And as I said, it was something which I could never think of that time, that I can, a person like me, who's not so brainy, no, not so intelligent, can complete CM first attempt. And then I joined some corporates, banks in various profiles, in audits, in typical finance roles. And I loved that journey. So I had no complaints. I learned a lot. Whatever I am today, I mean, I give the credit to my ex-bosses, the corporates I've worked with, the experience I've gained. But then at some point of time in my corporate life, I realized that I'm not creating a mark. That is not something which I really want to do. I mean, I had a very good salaries. I've been going up in the hierarchies. I was enjoying the corporate life. However, something was amiss. And then in 2011, I consciously decided to take a break. So a lot of my friends and colleagues said, you're too young to take a break at this stage. You're not retired, you're too young. I said, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I was blank. When I left the corporate, I did not know what I'm going to do with it. Then I left and then I just started this journey. So when I started into entrepreneurship, I was clueless what exactly what I'm going to do. But then it had its own path and I was simply following the path. So one of the certification which is very, very well recognized in the market is CFE, that is Certified Fraud Examiner. That's a US-based certification, but then that is something which is globally recognized. A small duration, not so expensive, not very difficult to crack. And that's the field which is quite in demand today, and it's gonna definitely be in demand for tomorrow. Fraud is not going anywhere. It's there today, it's gonna be there tomorrow as well. So your demand will never go out of fashion. That is field which is one, very exciting, and secondly, very remunerative. You won't find a lot of competition at this stage. So that's something which is gonna be a good career opportunity. And think out of box. I mean, don't just think about, just because you are a finance professional, you just don't need to be into numbers. Fraud investigation is beyond numbers. Can use your skill set there, nothing like that. So maybe you can take that path of learning investigation, getting more into cyber fraud investigation. That is another area which is absolute upcoming and quite in demand. A lot of people get trapped into social networks, social vulnerability, social engineering, where people have been cheated. Now you as a professional can support them, be it banking, be it just getting a friend request on Facebook and somebody's trying to cheat you on there. You can support them. So that's exactly the path. You have to develop a lot of skills as well, but then one certification will help you getting the basic knowledge. You have to be simply a graduate, so you don't need to be chartered accountant and you don't need to be from commerce stream either. You can be simply from any single stream. You can be engineer, art student, science student, it just does not matter. You can simply go through this, get a basic knowledge of it, and then get some more skill sets such as your interpersonal skills, communication skills, analytical skills. Now, these are the skills which will help you getting better into this profession. Mere certification would not help. So these kind of skills and soft skills, especially interpersonal skills, is very important for investigation. So again, I did not have any specific motivation, but yes, I did have few people in my corporate life who really influenced me a lot. So for example, one of my boss, Mr. Uday Prakash in Genpact, I still call him a boss. I'm still in touch with him, and I give him a lot of credit for what I am today. I mean, not really that he put in entrepreneurship in me, but then he made me realize what's my plus point, what is my strength, which I was not aware of. And gradually, with every person I work with, I realize that I'm good at explaining, I'm good at influencing people. And of course, some of people who I work with, they wanted me to upgrade the skill set. And that is where in 2012, I upgraded my skill set to the next level and learned the fraud investigation. That was something which was not part and profile of my work in a decade where I worked in corporate. When I was studying that certified fraud examiner thing, I realized that this is exactly what I want to do. Probably I'm meant for it. So investigation, analysis, absolutely, I love it. So that's where I realized that this is exactly what I want to do. And I've got really supportive people in my family also, being my mother, my family, my husband, everybody has supported so much that I really wanted to take it to the next level. So that's how we do this. So maybe I'll be very candid when I'll speak about my journey in entrepreneurship. So corporate journey was more of a smooth sail because of my qualification. And of course, I was lucky enough to get good opportunities. But then entrepreneurship was not something which is ever very easy process for anyone, be it a male or a female. And especially when you're female and into a domain which is absolutely a male-oriented domain, you have to really prove yourself. So when I thought about corporate investigation or a fraud kind of thing, which is absolutely an area where women are not heard of. And when people looked at me, first thing they had in their mind that, will she be able to do it? So I tell you one interesting instance. I went for a training in one of the organization where the average age of my audience would be about 50 plus. And I was in a normal t-shirt and jeans, and I went there for training, and they looked at me and said, we really don't know what we're going to learn. Maybe hardly 2 to 3 minutes in that training, and I started and post that these people really wanted me to come again and again and again for their training. So it's not just about your age. It's not about your gender. It is about your knowledge. That's what basically speak. Now, when we talk about support, the journey for female is, again, not so easy. I've been lucky that I've got people in my family, my friends, my colleagues, my bosses who've been really supportive, but that's not the case for everyone. I also face a lot of challenges in male-dominated world where I have to prove myself. A lot of people looked at me and sometimes they said, you are looking good in this, you are looking beautiful. But that's not what I wanted to hear. I wanted to hear that you are sounding intelligent. And that's, I wanted them to focus not on my face, but on what I'm saying. So that's something which you have to do gradually. But then if you are firm, you're confident, you can always create a mark. Say, of course, you always look back and you can improvise things. But then I was new. I was new to the city. I did not have any contacts. Of course, I took long time to do that. But this current scenario, when you have a lot of exposure on social networking and media, that's where people can create mark faster. My learning would be that, you know, one, that you should have more and more of exposures in terms of social networking and being more vocal about yourself. So my weakness was that I was not very open person, not going out too much. I was more of a closed person. So that's one of the things which I would like to improvise and would like to suggest people that if you want to get into entrepreneurship, you have to showcase what you are or what you have. If you can't showcase it, it'll become a challenge. So that's something which I would like to give up, my learning. I am Kamaljeet as a woman is a fighter now, and I love to be fighting. The only thing which I would tell all people who are looking at this is that don't give up. You know, the day you... So there are a lot of instances in my entrepreneurship where people have cheated. I thought to give up. I did not. So something somewhere inside me telling that you are not finished. People can take away your business. People can do anything to you. But then they can't take away what I have. My skill set and my confidence just cannot be taken away. So that's how I would put it. So fights are there. You have to be a fighter. Yes, pandemic has changed everything. So for example, my clients who used to shell out a good amount of money, now they really negotiate. One, that their priorities have changed. Secondly, in terms of remuneration, they've cut down the bills. So, of course, it is a very tough time. But the only way is to survive is to change. So we've been getting more into virtual mode. We've been getting into more into flexibility in terms of fees, in terms of working. And of course, a lot of things have changed in a virtual model. So we have been adjusting to that model. And that's something which we foresee as in future as well. The only thing, again, my piece of advice here would be keep adjusting to the current circumstances, whether in terms of delivery, in terms of flexibility, in terms of remuneration, or if not something in this model, keep up enhancing your skill set. Everybody sitting at home, the best we can do is upgrading ourselves. Don't become outdated. After 1 year, when you go back to job, you should not sound outdated. So for example, if I talk about something again related to my profession, cyber is something which I would all of you to think about, because even if you are not from investigation or CA background, getting more updated into digital part always helps. Everything is individual. See, we are talking in a digital model right now, but if somebody hacks this particular recording and changes what I'm saying and what you are saying,
yeah,
it can become a huge problem.
Mm.
So any kind of skill set which is related to digital will always support. Whether it is related to data analytics, whether it is related to digital forensics, digital investigations, or anything related to virtual, is something which I would always suggest is a very strong thing. For example, any young crowd here who's thinking about, let's say, internal audit. Now that's a profession which is becoming robotic worldwide. After a few years, robots will start doing it. So think about level next, more of data analytics, more of artificial intelligence. Enhance your skill set in that. I always tell all the young girls that no matter how strong is your family background today, before marriage or after marriage, don't just rely on that. Be on your own. It does not matter how much you earn, but then you earn, you have a skill set, you should be on your feet. You never know when you have to see the tough time. So that is first piece of advice. And second, don't, just because you have to deal with that challenge, don't give up in any manner. There may be a lot of threats, you know, being a female, we have to bear with a different kind of eyes also. So let's be very candid about it. There are chances when I go for training, when people are looking at me head to toe. I have to deal with it. So the different kind of challenges you have to face, whether it is work related, proving yourself, safeguarding yourself. Just be on your foot, be independent, be confident. And at any stage of time, don't feel so much of regret. Just because you're not able to give half an hour more to your family, don't feel guilty about it. It's fine. It is just fine. You can compensate it next day. But don't get into a trap of guilt every day. That will spoil everything. Here, I would like to tell that when I was expecting, so the 10th of August, he was born. Till 9th of August, I was working. And everybody was telling me crazy or what, but then I was still working and working and working. And a lot of people were joking around that he must have become an investigator by now, or learning inside only. And also, when he was just 1 month old, I had taken corporate trainings, having him in my lab. To go to my LinkedIn profile, you find some pictures of SBI Card where I was doing training, where the participants were holding my baby, because my baby used to go everywhere with me. I did not want to leave him until date. For almost 2 years now, I have not left him a single day alone. So wherever I go, he goes with me.